Winter weather this week, and that can be dangerous and can mean big waves out on the coast. In fact, a father and son got swept away and were never seen again earlier this month.
And now one Oregon State professor wants to help prevent something like this from happening again. Joseph Dames has a story.
Never turn your back on the ocean, they say.
The ocean is beauty and beast, right? It draws us to it because it's so beautiful and we want to spend time there, but it's also a really dangerous place.
Tuba Osgenhaller, a professor who focuses on water motions in the nearshore zone of the ocean, is doing research to solve the unusual event that we call sneaker waves.
This year are very large. We know that the slope of the beach is a big controller, and we know that whether or not the waves are narrow banded and swell-like, that's a big controller.
Jackie Simula of Seaside knows this coast all too well.
We never had any serious problems. I noticed we've seen logs in the water and always warned our children. Entrances to the beach, there's signs that talk about sneaker waves also that warn you about logs and sneaker waves. So that's another way, if people read that information.
But what if there's more information that could help? That is what Tuba is hoping to accomplish.
Most people, when they go to the beach, tend to just take a few minutes, really no longer than that, to assess whether or not it's safe. In reality, though, these unusual run-up events occur much less frequently than that, so within a few minutes, everything might look really regular, but 20 minutes later, you might have a very large run-up event that's going to get you wet. So a few minutes is just not enough to assess the danger level.
A plan that could eventually lead the public to safer outcomes.
We're working with the National Weather Service's local offices. Almost everybody who's at the beach these days has their smartphone with them, right? Is there a way to really get the information right into their phones?
And allow for those on the beach to be more aware of those dangerous sneaker waves. In Seaside, Joseph Dames, Point 6 News.
So the research is going to take a few years before it's finished, but hopefully gaining a better understanding of when and where these sneaker waves occur, and it'll help keep the public safe.
Coming up still at 6 o'clock tonight, the Dutch Bros making a